So, this is basically an article about a teen in the age of 19 kills herself as world closes in doing coronavirus lockdown. Alright. And, you know, you have to be really confused if you kill yourself because of a lockdown. Alright. But I guess she's a heathen, right? So, if you look in the Torah, you will see that the curses will overtake the heathens, alright? Because they switch over from the Israelites to the heathens, alright? That doesn't mean that basically the curses are not actually right now on us, alright? But the curses to the heathens will get so big that it's nothing compared to us, right? So even when curses are still on us, right, to that moment where Yahweh Shai returns, the curses will be so big at the heathens that actually it looks like there is no curse, no longer a curse on us, right? So that's what you have to keep in mind. Alright, let's read a... I think we can read the whole article because it's not that long. Alright. Emily Owen attempted to take her own life and later died in hospital as she could no longer cope with coronavirus worries. Alright. That's a picture of her. She even looks not, you know, not that bad, right? But you know, you don't mess with these heathen women, alright, in that time. Alright. Maybe she, if she is a virgin, maybe you can, you know, that's, you know, another topic, but better not mess with heathens, alright. Even when she is a virgin, whatever. A teenager who was always caring for other people has died after attempting to take her own life while terrified about the spread of coronavirus. Emily Owen, 19, tried to kill herself on Wednesday last week after feeling she could no longer cope with impending lockdown measures due to COVID-19, her family said. She was rushed into critical care at the Queen Elizabeth Hospital in King's Lynn, Norfolk, but failed to regain consciousness, and her family made the heartbreaking decision to allow her life support to be turned off on Sunday. Alright, so I guess she talked with her family, right? She told her secrets, you know, and they basically had the decision to make, and they said we will kill her because, you know, they talked about that, right, and they had the choice, alright. She was washed, they said she had been deeply affected by the global pandemic and had spoken of her wish to help people with mental illnesses navigate their own way through the isolation measures. That's basically what the martial law or the lockdown will bring, alright, because you have to think of that these people, these normal people, okay, I would say she's normal people out there, right, they basically doubt even sometimes that martial law or lockdown or something, or what it's coming, you know, with that Mark of the Beast and so on, will benefit them, alright? But, you know, actually, all these people with their gang stalking and whatever, you know, they basically think that this benefits them, alright? But it's only getting worse, especially if you're into these things, because it will bring more, more death and pain to you, alright? So basically, she had a good case, alright, I would say. Alright, she's just a heathen, alright, and we will read if she had the coronavirus, alright, but I think she had it and she was in the hospital, alright, and she was that sick that she, how many days or how many weeks, I don't know, she had, alright, in that moment, but the parents had to make the choice, right? In a Facebook post just before her death, Emily's parents, two sisters and brother, said they were living out the worst week of our lives. Right. They are now asking for people to watch out for vulnerable loved ones during the pandemic, to ensure no other lives are lost to suicide after Emily Waste fears a UK-wide lockdown. All right, and this is getting bigger in America, all right, because you have these people there. They basically have guns. Their whole life is on that mode, so to speak. So basically, this was, hard to see for the prophets, all right? Because these people are already in that mode, okay? Just has to be, some law implemented, and it will change everything, all right? And I suggest that you watch the video, Three Stages of Martial Law, all right? Because if you don't know it, all right, there are more stages of martial law, and only one stage can have tragic consequences, especially, for the heathen, but they think that it's actually good what they will face, all right, sometimes. In a Facebook post just before her death, Emily's parents, two sisters and brother said they were living out the worst week of our lives. They are now asking for people to watch out for. After Emily Waste fears a UK-wide lockdown would result in her world closing in. Let's see. For all the latest news and updates on coronavirus, click here. So I told you already they're lying with that numbers, and it's a pandemic, all right. Just knowledge is the stability of the times, right? And basically, if you know what's really going on, all right, then you will not maybe don't act like the most people, all right? On Saturday, the family wrote, "Our darling, beautiful, crazy daughter and sister tragically decided that she could no longer cope and tried to take her own life on Wednesday. She has been in critical care since then. The decision has been made today to turn off her life support tomorrow afternoon, giving time for the hospital to prepare for organ donation, something she signed up for in 2012 when she was only 12 years old. That sums her up, always caring for other people. Emily would have wanted you to check on your loved ones in these very difficult times, as she believed the fear of the unknown may drive them over the edge. She was planning on volunteering to help these people." All right, that's what she believed. All right. "The fear of the unknown may drive them over the edge." All right. And that's basically what you have, because the elect of Israel, all right, and anyway, the elect of Israel are the only people who will make it, all right, because they will hunt the elites, and then it's going into the kingdom, alright. And we know what's coming, alright. Even when some of us will die, you know. We know what's coming and we know that we will get spiritual powers, alright. So nothing happens to us, and martial law is a joke to us, alright. If we will get the spiritual powers, it's not even a joke. But these seeds have basically, you know, they have not any clue what our power is, alright. So they basically can think everything what they want, alright. It's just in vain, alright, because that unknown power is basically controlling everything, alright. So that's the problem with the heathens. You know, when you go into this whole deception, alright, it's the left hand of Yahweh, and you know, the left hand is just a hand of Yahweh, alright. So, you know, we know what's coming, right? Emily chose to donate her organs and will help save the lives of our people. East Anglia News Service. It's a picture from her, right? She looks not bad, you see? So, you know, she looks even better than the most women out there, right? See what happens. We appreciate all the amazing support we have already had and apologize in advance for not responding to all your loving messages during this difficult time. In a later post after Emily's death, they wrote, "We are all absolutely devastated but also immensely proud of everything she achieved in her life." So basically, you know, no one perishes without fault, you know, of course the elect, but you know, that's just a precept, alright, you should know the precept. You know, if you die, I don't know, alright. And that's what Esau Edom has done in his life, he achieved basically nothing, alright, because he's reincarnated. Alright, he's the reincarnation of the wicked seed, and what they achieved is basically not them, not of them or for them, alright, because they stole this, alright. So many people have messaged us over the past 5 days, but they still, you know, persecute the Israelites, you see, so that's the problem, see, and that's the unknown judgment, because this power, alright, is basically the people, alright. I will leave it with that, alright. Because it's the most highest eye apple, okay. So many people have messaged us over the past 5 days saying how Emily helped them through hard times of their own. And we had no idea how much positive impact she had on those around her. Right. Many people. That's also what these elites are saying, alright. So there's nothing coming good to your people out there, right? Because these elites caring about the normal people, alright, even not, you know, what you have with these secret organizations, alright. You have always the super elite, and they always think bad of the people under them, alright. And that's the people what we will hunt, alright, because, you know, they are the top of the top, alright. So you don't know what they're doing, alright. You see? They get hunted, alright. What you think will will this whole thing will benefit you, alright? Like, know what's coming, alright? Just saying, you know, because you have this, you know, this words here, too many people, alright? That's basically what the elite's saying, alright? And that's even eventually the reason why this whole coronavirus thing, alright, is now, you know, now the first, but not the last plague, alright? There will come more, you see? Emily was really fun, energetic, happy girl, alright, but she died. But only a few were aware of the many years of the internal battles she had. Few people are aware, but 4 years ago, she was diagnosed with high-functioning autism and had a daily battle to fit in a conform with social norms. Alright, sure, she was a little bit isolated, maybe. But if you are that beautiful, told you, you know, she's more beautiful than the most women out there. Right. It's not just her blonde hair, I would say. Right. You're not really isolated. You know, of course you have this beautiful woman, you know, nobody talks to her because basically even the, you know, even the men who do this the whole day, right, even they don't talk to a woman like that, so they basically isolated because nobody talks to the to her, right? But you know, I would not say that she was that, you know, that isolation woman, alright? I don't think so. Not that far, alright? Because she was happy, she was energetic, alright? But we don't know it. But only a few were aware of the many years of internal battles she had. Alright, so she had internal battles, alright. Few people are aware, but 4 years ago she was diagnosed. She didn't want anyone to know, but now she has gone. We want to make people know that autism comes in all shapes and sizes, you see. So the Most High, especially the Most High, doesn't care you who you are. That's what the elites will face, because they think they're basically godlike or something. And, you know, the Most High basically sees them just, you know, just what for what they are, all right? Heathens, Edomites, all right? And he knows their end. What is their end? Destroyed forever, alright? After the kingdom, because the kingdom will be 1,000 years slavery, alright? Hardcore slavery. If you look Planet of the Apes, alright, that's just an example. I don't want this to make, you know, to make it that long, but basically yesterday I had an conversation, and today I had a conversation, and, you know, if you know some heathen, whatever, alright, and she asked me, alright, she's a virgin also, alright, but she thinks for herself, alright, she's sure about that she is a Edomite, alright, and I said to her, you know, I will make you you will have maybe a place, you know, in my castle, alright, if you, you know, maybe you will be ever more a virgin, ever longer, you know, how long you want it, alright, and even your family, alright, in the kingdom, they may have a good place, because I will make it that way, alright, and as Israelite, as an elect, of course, you will remember, and you will know what people, you know, you had to do with within your life, alright, you know these people, you can, of course, locate them and, you know, do whatever you want, basically, alright. If you have, like, for example, somebody, you know, you can basically, you know, prison this person for, like, 1,000 years, but, alright, that's what Yahweh wants to give his people, alright? That's just a tool for what you can read in the Bible, alright? But we're not that unrighteous, alright? So we basically will know everything, alright? If you know everything, alright, you're basically righteous, alright? And we don't have to act like Esau, alright? Because first, we're not Esau, alright? We're not Esau, alright? That's basically the point. So, of course, I can make, you know, I can give you a good place, alright? I can give you your family a good place, alright? Because, of course, descendants will continue with their, not with their wickedness, but with their life in the kingdom, alright? 1,000 years, and you can read that somebody who will live with 100 years, alright? Is basically, that's basically not a high a high age, alright? See? And I think it's referring to the heathen also, right? Because we will live forever, alright? We will have that spiritual bodies, alright? That new bodies, alright? We will live, of course, over 1,000 years, alright? That's basically what these elites can't have, alright? So that's the whole point why they come out with this whole matter, alright? But I can't get it, because it was prophesied that they would never get it, alright? So this whole thing with Jacob stealed, so to speak, the birthright, alright? It was not even stealed, because, sehr lachen von mir Englisch, because it was sold, alright? If something is sold, it's not yours anymore, alright? But it was already prophesied, so it was never Esau's, alright? You see? So, you know, that's basically the point. We can pretty much do whatever we want, alright? These elites today, they can't do whatever they want, alright? Even when they think like that, because basically the Most High controls them, alright? Even if they don't want to believe it or whatever. We don't care, alright? You know, they even have a body, alright? Maybe they can make themselves an eyes, you know, and whatever, you know. I don't care, because basically they are just, you know, just men, alright? And we will be like gods, alright? Even the House of David will be in this lifetime as gods, alright? That's also what they may know eventually. You see? But let us continue here. Despite this, she managed to finish school, go to college, finish an apprenticeship and start working in the king's arms. Please look out for people, be kind, as you never know what is going on in people's lives, you see? They added that Emily's wish to the nature origins had been followed, giving hope to four families, three of them children who are starting new lives as a result. The king's arms popped in Chulham, Norfolk, where family worked for 2 years. And I basically, you know, I told that heathen virgin, alright, that she, because she asked me if there's no hope for her, you know, and I said to her that first off, many virgins and whatever woman, you know, will die, alright, because I told you only the elect will make it, alright. There's also coming very cruel judgments, alright, basically for the wicked woman, you know, and basically I said that Esau Edom, alright, is Satan, basically, the seed line of Satan, and you have the seed line of man, because I saw that actually yesterday at evening, it was a video from my brother, GMS of course. And he said also that the seed of man is the other heathens, alright? So you have the heathens, they are just, you know, human, no normal human, all right, because we are all human at this point. You have Esau Edom, who is basically Satan and his seedline, all right, and you have sons of the Most High, all right, and that's we, the Israelites, you see. So of course there's a difference, and there's no right unrighteousness with God. And if there is no unrighteousness with God, all right, I can even tell you what after the kingdom will happen, but I can tell you, of course, that I can give you a good place, all right, and your family also, all right, because we are basically in control of these things in the kingdom, all right. And even when these whole things will escalate on this earth, right? But you will see it, all right. And she said also at one point that I maybe will not longer, know her or something, all right. But you better believe me, all right. In the kingdom, okay. You can't hide from us. You can't. We know just by closing our eyes, all right, where you are, who you are, what you have done, all right. That's maybe what Esau, Edom, and the human beings, the other human beings, will not understand, all right. That's not what you call. Human fantasy anymore, because it will be spiritual, all right, and it always starts spiritual, and then it comes to the materialistics, all right. So basically, that was a little bit funny, all right. Please look out for people, be kind, as you never know, all right. They added that Emily's wish to donate her organs had been followed, giving hope to four families, three of them children who are starting new lives as a result. The King's Arms pub in Chultenham, Norfolk, where Emily worked for 2 years, is now raising money in her memory for Norfolk and Waveney Mind. Emily was worried about the impact of strict lockdown, and you have these places, they basically look like ghost towns. All right. But, even that will change, because these whole houses will look desolate, all right. And, just keep that in mind, all right. It starts always like this low level, all right, and then it will. It will increase. The sorrow will increase, all right, because this is only the beginning, all right. So, suffering with mental health problems, all right. So, this will start and increase, all right. Selachia Abipens, Panks, Vice Chairman of Chultenham Community Enterprises. Just saying, okay, you don't know her, so I can talk a little bit about her. She is basically, I know her for, or since, basically where I started the whole thing with coming in the tooth, all right, and she's still a virgin, all right, so in the age of, I think she's 21, or 21 or 20 or something, all right. And you don't have that often today, all right. So there has to be a spiritual awareness for that, all right. It has to be that way, because especially Edomites don't, into this stay, just don't have sex with anybody who comes, around the corner, right? You don't have that often, especially with Isao Eden. Alright. So, you know, she's basically a humble person, and I liked it, alright. And, you know, maybe she will be in my place in the kingdom, alright. I will, you know, I will do that, of course, I can, alright. But we will see. Abby Pence, vice chairman of Schuldheim Community Enterprises, which runs the pub, said Emily was a whirlwind of energy, so caring and funny, truly beautiful inside and out. She was loved by our team and customers alike. She was also an incredibly talented artist. The team are understandably heartbroken. We are going to miss Emily enormously. She was a part of our family here. She added, We are heartbroken that we won't see her breeze through our doors like a tornado of energy again. Her distinctive laugh. If you would like to donate to the Norfolk, okay, so this goes on another page, right? You know, we won't go there, you know. And basically, you know, this is really a beautiful teenager, alright? And, you know, this can happen to anybody at any time. And nobody is safe from Yahweh, especially not the woman, alright? And I don't hope that, you know, my friend, alright, will face something like that, alright? But basically, she's my enemy, alright? She knows that, alright? And, you know, she knows also that we are the Hebrew Israelites, okay? And she also believes me when I say things, alright? But that doesn't change that she is basically our enemy. You see, but just for you, for edification, all right. You have these people out there, right? And you don't know what the Most High, you know, what the Most High will do unto them because they are reincarnated, all right. So it has to come something, all right. And that's also where the spirit kicks in, you know, because I don't know what will happen to her in this lifetime. But I know what will happen in the kingdom, alright? I can simply take her, alright? Not as my first wife, alright? Because we have Israelite wives in the kingdom as our first wives, as our handmaids. And under the Israelite woman will be this hidden woman, alright? And of course you can decide who will be under our woman, alright? You can decide that. Okay? You can basically decide everything when it comes to your place, so to speak, alright? So, this will, you know, this will take place, alright? Because you have this humble people out there, alright? And, you know, many virgins will perish, alright? What you think will happen to the people who don't have this gospel, especially from the Israelites? See? When the judgment will begin at our house, you see? So, you know, that's basically it. You know, don't kill yourself, alright? Don't do that because, you know, just keep the Torah, alright? And I told you, everybody has to keep the Torah, alright? It's just the truth, alright? Because the human being, alright, is there to keep the Torah, alright? And you will see that in the kingdom, at least, alright? Even if you are heathen, alright? You will see that, alright? Because this is the world of the sons of God, alright? So, you know, that's just what it will, where it will end, alright? Because the world was made for our sakes, alright? So you can't say, okay, I would not, you know, I didn't told you so, alright? There's also blood on your hands, what can be what the Most High will you know want to have it back, all right? If you don't want the people, the heathens, all right? And heathens are Israelites also. Second Esdras 6, 59. If the world now be made for our sakes, do we not possess an inheritance with the world? Of course not, okay? Because Esau, Edom, alright, this is his kingdom. And this is his inheritance, you see? So, alright. How long shall this endure? You see? So you really think that the Israelites can do something like that in the kingdom? Alright. We will be as gods, alright? Like Esau, Edom in this lifetime, okay? We basically even don't know what, you know, happened with herself, alright? So, just saying, alright? This was a little faith builder also to you, alright? And I hope you received some information, some edification out of it. And you know, just keep doing the work, and you will not fall. See? And with that, Bogdaya, 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 all praises, all right, to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Halleluja. We're almost out of here, all right. The chariots are already, even in the media, all right, because Esau can no longer hide it, you see. It's all, you know, it's all already set up, right? We wait just for Yahweh's next move, and it will happen, you see. You're almost out of here. Shalom.